A few weeks ago, my DeLorean started stalling when I'd come to a stop. It would start fine and it would drive fine, but when I got to a stop sign or a traffic light, there was a pretty good chance that the RPMs are going to drop low, and if I wasn't quick enough on the throttle, it would probably stall. It didn't seem to matter if the engine was warmed up or not, but it also wasn't completely predictable. Sometimes I could get through a few stops, but once it started stalling on me, it would stall through the rest of my trip. Now, this is not a stock DeLorean by any means. I have made a lot of changes over the years, one of which was adding electronic fuel injection as part of an engine swap. So the first thing I did was I pulled out the laptop and plugged it into the Megasquare ECU so I could look at what it thought was happening in Tuner Studio. This gauge shows the air-fuel ratio. It's supposed to be pointing up most of the time. It definitely should not be pegged all the way to the left, especially not when idling. This probably means that there's something wrong with the oxygen sensor. I'm not entirely sure that a bad oxygen sensor is causing the car to stall like this, but I should replace it anyway. Let me start by explaining what an oxygen sensor does and why this car even has one to begin with. There's an ideal mixture of air and fuel that will completely burn the fuel, thus generating the most amount of power and the best fuel efficiency. This is called the stoichiometric ratio. For gasoline, that ratio is 14.7 parts air to 1 part fuel. All fuel-injected cars, including a stock DeLorean, use an oxygen sensor to determine how completely the fuel was burned. By measuring the amount of oxygen in the exhaust gas, the ECU can compute the true air-fuel ratio and adjust the fuel flow to get closer to the ideal ratio. If there was too much air, the engine's said to be running lean, and too much fuel means it's running rich. A factory-tuned car will come with a simple, narrow-band sensor. You'll sometimes see this referred to as a lambda sensor. Lambda is just the air-fuel ratio normalized so that one is stoichiometric. Above one is lean and below one's rich. The catch is, a narrowband sensor can only tell you that a lean or rich condition exists. This is fine if you have a pre-tuned, mass-produced car, but if you want to tune the fuel tables yourself, you need to know exactly how rich or lean the engine is running. And for that, you need a wideband sensor. These are more expensive than narrowband sensors. They need special controllers to talk to the ECU, they have built-in heaters, and they need to be periodically calibrated by removing them from the exhaust. But this is the only way to properly tune an engine. Stock DeLoreans use narrowband sensors, partly because they're cheaper, but partly because they don't need anything more. But this car has been upgraded to EFI. I need to tune the fuel tables myself, so I installed a wideband oxygen sensor. If the sensor isn't working properly, the ECU won't be able to provide the right amount of fuel. At worst, your car might not run properly at all, although this isn't very likely. You'll probably just lose some power and a bit of fuel efficiency. So, does any of this have anything to do with my stalling problem? Maybe not. But I checked the light on the wideband controller and it's blinking the error code for a sensor fault, so there's definitely something wrong here. Swapping out the sensor isn't a big deal. You just unscrew the old one and screw in a new one. This shouldn't take very long. Yeah, that took way too long. That sensor did not want to come out. I tried a wrench, nothing. I tried a cheater bar on the wrench, but only succeeded in rounding the corners of the sensor and making it even harder to get out. I heated it with a map torch until it glowed red, still nothing. I ordered a set of oxygen sensor sockets, which I should have had in the first place, and which I had to hammer onto the sensor because of how much I'd rounded it, and it still wouldn't turn. I finally resorted to drilling it out. I got the header out of the car so I could cut off the top of the sensor with an angle grinder. I then tried to drill the rest of it out with my drill press, but I somehow just melted a drill bit on whatever is inside the sensor. So I stuck the sensor in a vise and I tried to melt the internals away with an oxyacetylene torch. All that did was make a puddle of molten internals that I still couldn't get out. So I went back to the drill press and went slower this time to keep my bits from melting. And I was actually able to drill it out with successfully larger bits. The last remaining piece I tapped out with a screwdriver so that I wouldn't damage the threads any more than I already had. I did run a chaser down the sensor port to make sure the threads were cleaned up as much as they could be. And then I was able to get the new sensor in, but it's kind of tight. I don't really like it, but it seems like it's as good as I'm gonna get. As long as I can get it out again. And this time I made sure to use lots of anti-seize. I think that's why it got stuck in the first place. I probably forgot to put any on last time I calibrated it. I won't forget that again. Anyway, it's back in the car. Tuner Studio is showing proper oxygen levels, so at least that works. Hopefully this fixes the stalling. Crap. At some point when I was poring over the settings in Tuner Studio, desperately trying to figure out what I was doing wrong, I noticed that there was an option to only idle when the throttle was below a certain level. And then I noticed that my throttle position sensor wasn't showing zero when I was stopped. A throttle position sensor is just what it sounds like. You push the pedal, the throttle opens, and the sensor reports how open it is. When you let go, it's supposed to spring back to closed with the throttle, but mine sticks open. I've tried three different sensors and they all stick, so it's not the sensor. None of them spring back until I loosen the mounting bolts, but then it's not able to do its job anymore, and it creates a vacuum leak. Here's the thing about throttle position sensors. They're nice to have because they give the ECU a hint about what you, as the driver, are actually doing. But it's also optional. Stock DeLoreans don't even have one. Since mine wasn't working anyway, I just disabled it by shorting the sense pin to ground. This means that it should be reading zero all the time. It's been that way for a couple of years and it's been working fine. And because I disabled it, I'd been ignoring all the throttle position settings in Tuner Studio. But the sensor isn't reading as disabled anymore. It's showing seemingly random values, which I also didn't pay attention to because I thought it was disabled. These were usually small values between like 0 and 2 or 3%, but once when I was debugging it, it spiked up to 50%. That's definitely not right. Well, it turns out the wire I tied to ground had come loose. In electronics speak, this meant the sense wire was floating, meaning it had no specific voltage on it and was just acting like an antenna, picking up random RF noise and passing that on to Megasquirt instead of saying that the throttle was closed. Which brings us to this setting. The ECU was told to only idle when the throttle was less than 1%, but noise on this loose wire would sometimes bring it above that. In those cases, the ECU would never go into idle mode, so it wouldn't correct for low RPMs and the car would stall. So I fixed the loose wire. Now the car idles properly again. The oxygen sensor was completely unrelated, but now that I've replaced it, the car should run more efficiently and have a little more power. And I really should figure out how to get a throttle position sensor that actually works sometime, but that's a project for the future. At least now I can drive my car and not worry about it stalling. Well, not from this anyway. Thanks for watching. If you want to know more, there are detailed links in the description below. And you can also check out one of these other fine videos.